Hello everyone, in this video we have a quad circle and a square whose corners lie on this quad circle. And here the side is given 2 units and here is given 3 units. And then O is the center of the quad circle and X is asked. Okay, first of all, you know that here is 90 degrees because of quad circle, and these are also 90 degrees because of square. Let's call here alpha, here theta. You know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? Therefore, here must be equal to theta, and this angle here must be equal alpha. Okay. So now, to find x, I want to turn the length of x into the hypotenuse. So let's draw a perpendicular. That means here must be equal theta, right? Okay. After that, I want to draw one more perpendicular at the location of 2, because it can't be given without a reason, right? Therefore, here must be equal alpha, right? Okay. If you notice that, we get 3 congruent triangle, right? So we know that congruent triangles have same side and angles. That means if there's a 3 unit opposite of the theta, opposite of the theta here must be equal 3 units. Likewise, here is also 3 units, and let's call here m unit. We know that radius of the quad circle is 5, right? So if here is 3 plus m, that means 2 minus m left here. Okay, so if opposite of the alpha equal 3 minus m, that means opposite of the alpha here must be equal 2 minus m. Likewise, this length is also 2 minus m. Next step, we know that radius of the circle equals 5. That means m unit left here, right? Okay. And then, if we apply power of a point formula for this point, notice that if we extend here, if it is 3, that means this side must be equal 3 units. Right? And if you complete the bottom as a full circle like this, so now we can easily apply power of a point formula. Therefore, 3 times 3 equal this part m times this part 10 minus m. Right? Therefore, 9 equal 10m minus m squared. If we organize the equation, so m squared minus 10m plus 9 equals 0. These are negative 9 and 1, and here is m times m. So m minus 9 times m minus 1 equals 0. That means m equal 9 and m equal 1. Okay, which one is true? If you notice that, here is 2, right? That means 2 is greater than m, so this one is cancels out. Therefore, m equal 1 unit. And then if you focus on this triangle, let's draw here. here is 90 degrees, and this length is 2 minus m, and here is m, and hypotenuse is x, right? So we know that m equal 1, that means these are 1 units, so x equal root 2. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x, let me click here, using second method. The second way is more practical than the first one. First of all, if we connect these two corners, we know that radius of the quad circle equal 5. That means this red line must be equal 5 units, right? Because of radius. And notice that there's a 3 units here. If you focus on this triangle, that means this triangle is 3, 4, 5, right triangle. So here must be equal 1 unit. So 1 unit left here. And notice that if there's a 1 unit opposite of the alpha, opposite of the alpha must be equal 1 unit. Likewise, opposite of the alpha here is also 1 unit. So we know that radius of the quad circle equal 5. That means 1 unit left here. As a result, we get an isosceles right triangle. So if there's a 1 unit opposite of the 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees must be equal root 2. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.